You're listening to Spirituality in Business, a compilation of conversations with Emmy Award-winning journalist Jenniffer Weigel from her podcast, I'm Spiritual, Dammit. For more books written or hosted by Jenniffer, visit her website, jenweigel.com.
Welcome to I'm Spiritual, Dammit. I'm Jenniffer Weigel, and joining me in studio, Julie Murphy Casserly. She is a money expert, author of Emotions Behind Money and Awaken Your Wealth, and the founder of JMC Wealth Management. Julie, thanks for being in the studio.
Absolutely. You're very welcome.
So we met when I was a Tribune columnist, and a mutual friend said, you gotta meet my friend Julie. She's not your typical money manager. And I'm like, okay, first of all, I don't know if I could even wrap my head around that sentence, not your typical money manager, because I have this, you know, belief system that people who manage money are, sorry, but like, you know, white guys over 50 that, you know, count your pennies and they're
average
really rich.
Age is 58 years old.
Okay, so there you go.
You're totally right.
They're rich and you're not, and you're like, what's going on? But how did you get into this world? Because you aren't your typical money manager. You believe in a lot of energy and spirituality that kind of comes into your work, but not in a woo-woo, I'm head in the clouds kind of way.
Right.
In a very practical kind of way. Yep. When did this become a passion for you?
Well, so I am one of 12 children. And so, and I'm at the top of the stack.
Okay.
And so when I went away to school, there was no way I was going to go into something like sales and not use my degree. And that's actually how I started in this industry. Cause I was like, oh my God, if I paid for myself to go through college, that I was going to apply my degree and, but also be the outgoing personality that I am.
Right.
And so when I started to realize I was not the blue suit. And my very first boss said to me, you know what? You have to stop hugging your clients when they walk in the door. And I looked at him like he had 10 heads because I'm like, what do you mean? Yeah. You're talking about the birth of their children, the death of their loved ones, and all the money and everything in between, and you can't hug them?
That's
like,
not
I
right.
thought that,
yeah.
And that was that, you know, white male who's, you know, in his 50s, and at the time he was in his 40s. And,
right.
You know, and I started this 21 years ago, and going into the business, and then when I decided to just let my freak flag fly and say, you know what, I'm just doing it differently. Then all of a sudden, you know, as life aligns, the gentleman who actually convinced me to go into this industry when I was down at the University of Illinois actually showed up one day as my boss, and that old management regime was replaced.
Wow.
And he goes, I know you. I'm like, yes, you do. Mm-hmm. And to this day, he is one of my mentors. And he just told us what to do because he thought the industry was actually going to get into some trouble,
right.
which we currently sit in,
right?
With
of course.
Economic challenges.
Sure.
And he said, if I were to do it all over again and I didn't have a family and I didn't have kids at this point, I would start to really operate as the client advocate and hang your own shingle.
Right.
And so at 27 years old, I actually then incorporated and opened up. And what I decided to do is that if I'm really trying to represent the clients, well, let the clients tell me what they want. And so I surveyed them and had them tell me that they really were searching for somebody to be their advocate.
Right.
But then they also didn't know how to navigate the financial product side, whether it be insurance or investments. And I was like, okay, which means that it needs to be twofold. It needs to be, okay, how do you help be somebody's advocate when the only way that you're compensated is actually by buying a product? And that's where I found the biggest disconnect. Because money is energy.
Yeah.
And we have to energize what we want people to be or what we want our financial intentions to be. So that's when we decided to actually charge a consulting fee to help people with their finances. And people were like, thank God. They were happy to write the check for that because then we were in energetic right alignment.
And you were giving them clarity.
Yeah, and then I didn't care whether or not, like I did build a team to help them implement their plans in certain areas, but then I built strategic alliances to do it in other areas that we weren't expert in. And so that we could help them from a holistic standpoint to really help them to get them where they're at. And what's very interesting to me is that come April 1st, of 2017, we now have a Department of Labor regulation that is coming down like a bull in a china shop on this industry.
Right.
Where when they did it in Australia, 60% of advisors all left the industry. And in the UK, 55% of advisors left the industry.
What are they going to do in April of 2017?
Yeah.
How are they going to change
so
that?
So we're already seeing some of that trickle-down effect. So you've got State Farm as an example just said they will no longer let their agents service IRA retirement accounts. So you're going to have to call an 800 number if you're a customer of State Farms
okay.
and you bought an IRA through them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.